To this now, community health workers in the Eastern Cape are feeling neglected by the provincial government. They're stating that theory working conditions are not up to their required standards. They are also asking that they be given full time and not work on a casual basis. Now, for more on the story, I'm joined on the line by Anele Mbi, who is a community health worker. Anele, thank you so much for talking to us. What is causing you to feel neglected by the provincial government? What is causing the health workers to feel neglected by the provincial government in the Eastern Cape?
Yeah, okay, thank you very much. Good afternoon to the viewers as well. The major problem that we're having now is underemployment and exploitation of community health workers by the Eastern Cape Department. The Eastern Cape Department has been refusing to employ them. They have been signing contracts each and every year, contracts, one-year contracts. So they are treating them as volunteers, and we're not happy with that, because in terms of the Labor Relations Act, that is not supposed to be the situation. And then we have also confirmed with the Labor Department that the workers, the care workers, are workers in the true sense of the word. They are not the volunteers.
And Anele, when it comes to obviously the department, I'm sure you may have tried to get some answers when it comes to this particular issue. What are you being told?
Yeah, you know, it's not the first time that we're waging a war against the government. This has been going for a long time. And most of the time, the MECs, for instance, the MEC, the previous MEC, they refused to answer even our memorandum. We went to peace, so we came with memorandums, we masked, we did sit in, but they're not accountable, they're not giving answers. But at least when we were there yesterday, and even yesterday, she couldn't come. They were saying she's been in Eastern, and we didn't know what she was doing, but she couldn't come. But the SG came, the superintendent general came. And then he committed himself to respond to us within 7 days to all our demands.
Now, Anele, I want us to look at this issue. How critical is the work of community health workers, particularly during such a pandemic?
Yeah, it's so critical. It's worrying because many of them are dying, if you know. And the thing is, they have been dying even before COVID, because of the age, because of the others. They contracted sickness. If you remember, the CWs were working on TB and HIV/AIDS. That's how they started to volunteer with the department. So they've been dying, and the worst part of it is that when they passed away, the health department just go, even they go to the funeral, they just say thank you, but there's nothing, there's no support, there's no compensation for them. It's only the stipend that they are earning, the 3,500, which was only introduced last year. They've been earning 2,000, and they've been earning, ever since they were employed. You see, so the problem we're having now is that now they're on the front line of the fight against the pandemic, and then all these, they're so nervous. I mean, all these issues, the problems, social problems they're having, the sick problems that they are having, and the fact that they fear the virus themselves, and there's been a lack of PPEs. So all that is coming to their mind. That's why now they are angry. They said, now, okay, this is the opportunity now that they must raise their issue so that the provincial authorities can health authorities can respond positively to their demand of permanent employment. Because we're saying that community health work or care work is a professional work. And then why are they not recognized as public service workers? Because they are working for government, but they are not in the public service domain.
Anele, I want to probe something that you said there in your answer, that there's lack of PPE. Let's look at just how well resourced are these community healthcare workers, and what a crisis it is when it comes to this lack of PPE that you're describing.
Yes, you see, the problem in the Eastern Cape is that there's been a health crisis even before the arrival of COVID. We've been raising challenges of shortage of staff. And then shortage of community health workers, shortage of nurses, shortage of doctors and equipment. And especially in the rural areas, you find that the clinics are far and then the hospitals are far from the communities, you see. So that's a problem. And even if when we were discussing the health insurance, we say that this is going to be a problem because there's a lot of shortages in our health facilities. So now COVID came and to expose even the crisis further of shortage of staff. And mind you, if many of the staff now, health workers, are sick and they're on quarantine, they were in shortage already. So that's the cause of the crisis. Now you find that even care workers who were tested and then were still waiting for the results, they are forced to go to work, you see. And in some cases, they are not protected.
Let's look at the issue of community health workers here and PPE. And you say that there is a lack of supply when it comes to this particular issue. Are we at crisis level?
Yes. Because it depends on other clinics. Other clinics, they do have, but other clinics, they are running short of them. So that's a problem. But we're saying that this is very, very important because because the health workers cannot go out to the field and remain at the health facilities without protection. They need to be the sanitizers and masks. They need to be available at all times.
And Anele, just as a final question from me, why is it so important for community health workers to be employed, permanently, particularly for somebody who doesn't understand? How will this change the lives of the community healthcare workers?
Okay, thanks. I think that's a very, very important question. I think what you need to understand first is that the majority of community health workers are women. They are women. I think 99% of them are women. You see, and then they are breadwinners in their household, and suffering of those women means suffering of their families as well. I think what we are saying is that the government must lead by example. The government has got nice labor relations act, it's got a nice constitution in this country, and then we expect also the private sector to comply with the constitution. But if the very same government, which is the guardian of the law of the constitution, is not respecting the rights of our people, and then it's perpetuating cheap labor, because behind all these things is exploitation. So you find that community health workers, they are not only doing following up TB patients and HIV at clinics. They do some work. Others they supply medicine. Others they do the other work at the clinics to help the shortage of staff, you see. So it's very important for us to improve their social being, because most of them even when they pass away, no one is there. There's nothing for their children or their families. Yeah? So we say this is very, very important, especially for South Africa, because these are women and these are working class women who are suffering. No one. There's no one who's defending them. They take care of everyone in society, but they know there's no one who's taking care of them. So we think that the employment, full employment of community health workers will improve their lives, and it will also improve their output in terms of their work. Look, these community health workers, they go to the community, and they go to impoverished people, they go to sick people, but they are also impoverished. Some of the people that they visit, they do not have even bread, and then they must even take out of their pocket because they see the crisis. So we're saying that because the community health workers are playing a primary role in primary health care, I think they should be afforded the right so that they can do their work thoroughly.
Thank you so much, Anele. The Anele Mbi, who is a community health worker in the Eastern Cape, taking us through what he calls the plight of community health workers in that province there.